Hey, welcome back guys. Welcome to lecture 14. So today we'll see the ADS layout part. And if you could remember from last lecture, like we have started this one from lecture 11. There we have started with designing one maximum gain amplifier design, and we have tried with the Serenade software, which is don't have so much of sophisticated things, and we need to do many things manual there. Okay. And then in lecture 12, what we did the automation with ADS, and in lecture 13 we also saw how to optimize our circuit easily with ADS, which is not possible with Serenade. So if you want to haven't seen these videos, then please see them if you want to know how to do using only Serenade, because sometimes you don't have the access to ADS. You can see it especially in lecture 13 what we did. If you remember, we have made these circuits, and we have from this result we have optimized our result to this one, and this is a very good response actually. So if you are interested, you can see my lecture 13. Today we'll start with lecture 14. So let's start. And before starting, for those who are new here, myself Rasdeep Majumdar, I am currently working with Intel as automation design engineer, and also I have done my master's from IIT Delhi. So if you are interested for this type of video, and also in future I'll bring out more technological videos, especially on the field of electronics, then I'll be very happy if you could consider to subscribe my channel. So here it is open for you, and this step one, or you can say step two, we have done in our lecture 12 and lecture 13. In lecture 13 we have tried with this optimization tool. So I'm not recalling those things because they are already recorded. You can anytime you can go there and you can see. Today what I'll do, I will try to draw the layout for this schematic. So for doing layout there are many methods, but today I am showing you just one method. And this way I feel comfortable, so I am letting you know that this way. You can see this layout. You need to go to layout and see we have a few options, two options. You can use both of them, no issue, but I like to use this option, place component from schematic layout. So you click here, then this layout will open, layout window will get open, and let us make them side by side so you can compare like what is our layout and what is our schematic. So you can see some changes here. Our schematics every level have these red boxes. These red boxes means they are not present in our schematic, in our layout, and you can see layout is empty here, so nothing is there. That's why we are getting all the red thing. So what we do, we just click here and we just bring it here without any dragging. I am not dragging it. Okay, I am just clicking it here. I am releasing my click button and I am clicking next here, and you can just observe this, they are snapping here. Okay, so actually in my preference, in my layout, the snapping is on, and might be it is off for you. And if snapping is off, then it can might go overlapped or something, like it is not easy. So to make the snapping on, you right click on this blank space, you go to preference, and in preference you can see here enable snapping. So you can enable it, and there we have many other things also. You can set it as per your requirement. So now we will bring this one. Actually this way will face one problem, and I'll let you know what's the problem in little while. See, this is your one SNP box, perfect, and this SNP box has no layout components. It is showing something cross. That means it don't have any footprint in the layout system, right? And in a practical sense, what we will do, we will design this layout and we will left some blank space here or for this discrete component, because our SNP is nothing but our FET, and this FET will buy it from our vendor in offline or online, and after getting it we will shoulder it to our this layout. So that means what we need to do, we need to between this section and like this section, we can have other section, I am not bringing it here now, we need to have some specific gaps. Okay, and these gaps we don't know now, How we will come to know? We'll come to know by seeing the data sheet of that discrete component, that discrete component which you are using. So, and here also, like we like for example, we know it is 5 millimeter, right? So what we can do, we can bring the scale here and we can just know this is the 5 millimeter separation, and after that we can place it. This is one way to bring the scale. You can press Ctrl M and you can click here and here. So double click here to finish it. You can see here it is around 40 micrometer. So you can do it, but I don't prefer this way. What I prefer, I'll show you. Let us delete this one. Don't save it and don't do anything here. What I do, I will create another schematic layer, and this is just my way. You can choose your way. Once you do it, you can know which way you feel comfortable. But the my way, how I do, let us delete this layout. I just choose to copy this one. Like I want one new copy, and let us write it as step 2. And okay, so we got a copy of schematic here, and what I do, I just delete this one and let us create some space, and you go here, you go to T-line microstrip line, and see here we have M gap. So you bring this M gap here and join it, and in this M gap you put S is means your separation, W is not the issue here, just put your separation and see your data sheet for your discrete component. And for example, for right now we'll take it as 5 millimeter, just the example. Okay, you need to see it in your spreadsheet, like how much separation should be there for a perfect shouldering. So you need to see that one. So okay, and then the same step, I'll go to layout, I'll place component from the schematic, I will place both the windows side by side, and now it's simple. Choose it, choose next, and we will do it for all the components here. For this gap, you connect it here and see this gap is auto, like it is for sure it will be 5 millimeter, so we don't need to bring those scale and those dirty things. It is too easy now. And then bring this one, and don't forget to enable your snap, because snapping is very make it easy, like our schematic layout creation become very easy. So this schematic is almost ready. We can cut it here. Save it. Okay, so our schematic is all ready. Now what we need to do, we need to do the EM analyzation here, and then what we'll do, we will do the core simulation. Now many of you might be don't know what is core simulation, so for now hold it, I'll tell you what is core simulation. For core simulation, what we do actually, we will do the EM thing here. We will get the symbol of this layout, and we will bring this symbol out to one new schematic, and that schematic we will add our SNP box here, our terminals here, 50 ohm, and then we will run the same simulation here which we have done in our schematic world. Our schematic world means this world. Okay, so there, what we will do in our schematic, we'll replace this part with our layout symbol, and layout symbol will give us the exact result, because that one is created from the EM of the exact layout. So that is actually called the core simulation. So for that, what we need to know, or what we need to do, is to put the pins here, because if we don't put the pins, then in schematic we can't join outside thing here. So for pin, you can see here we have here option pin, or you might be have some keyboard shortcut also, you just see it. I'm forgetting, I can't remember right now, you can see it. But if you don't know, you just click here in the pin and you will just connect it here and here. These two pin we know for sure, because we will add terminals here. But we need additional pin here and here also, because we will add one external SNP box here also. So we need it. If you don't like this pin size or this text size, then you can again do the same thing. You go to preference, and in placement, this is your pin size. So you can increase your pin size, like I can increase this up to 5000, so it will become big, or if you don't like it, you can change it. 1000 is okay actually. Likewise, you can change the text also. Everything you can modify from the preference. You can explore that option. Okay, after that, the important things. Let me go to EM, and if I click simulate, you can see it now in EM. If I click simulate, it will show me one error. There is no current EM setup. So do you want to create one? So we can click yes also, or what we can do, we can just go EM and we can select this second option, simulation setting, or shortcut is F6. So go here and create your EM simulation setup. So there are few templates are there, like for antenna, MIC, RF board, but we will go with none and create EM setup. Now in EM setup, you will see one thing. We have some issue here, and what's the issue? We don't have any substrate. We have the port, we have connected already the port, we have connected. Frequency planning already is there, 0 to 10 gigahertz, and our frequency is, I think, 8 gigahertz, 8 or 6 gigahertz, I'm not sure. So it is also okay, but substrate, we have some issue. So if I click on substrate, what it is showing? It is showing no valid substrate found. This is because we have not created any substrate till now. So we need to create a substrate for a EM simulation, because in EM simulation, unlike your schematic simulation, in EM simulation they consider your substrate also, because actually in schematic also we consider our substrate, this M sub, you can remember we have given there, but in layout we don't need to write it like M sub. We need to provide them a 3D exact 3D model of the substrate for exact for correct EM simulation. So what we need to do now, we need to create one substrate. So we'll click new and see, we have few templates already there, but if your substrate is one layer or two layer, then 25 million alumina is the best one. You can we will modify it now. So after selecting it, you can create, modify it, and we will modify it. So we will modify it. We will go to here. This is your dielectric. This is your air. So air, we won't touch it. It is okay. We'll go to dielectric. We will change. We can drop down. See, we are not getting the things which we want actually. Why? Because see, in our substrate, what we have? We have epsilon RS 2.21. So that means we need a dielectric which have a 2.2 and other things. So we need to customize this dielectric. So for that, what we can do, we can go to this 3 button and we can select our dielectric from the database. So if we find out our, like, Roser is there, like this is very popular, many times we use Roser. So if you know your substrate is out of one of these, then you can select it directly and done. But now in this question, actually our substrate is not some standard substrate. This is just I have taken there one example. So I need to make that substrate. So to make your own substrate, what you can do, you can just go to add dielectric. See, dielectric 2 is there, and you can write down everything what you need. So we need 2.2 of epsilon r. Our 10 delta is 0.0005. This is I'm taking from the example. And other thing, you can write down if you have the values, but in this question we don't have, because this is our own substrate and we are taking only the necessary items only. So dielectric 2 is our required substrate. So I'll click OK. And now if you go to your drop down, you can see we have dielectric 2. So we will select a dielectric 2. Now our dielectric 2 should have some height, and what's the height? In M sub it is 508 micrometer. So we'll come here, we'll write 508, and it is mil, we can change it to micrometer, and everything other is okay. Now see, this is your conductor area where the main thing will come on, like main pattern will generate using this conductor area. So you click here, this conductor should come above your interface, right? This is like microstrip line, and we are designing using microstrip line. So this is the microstrip line. Like for microstrip line design, we need to have our conductor above our dielectric medium. we can select copper, anything, like we can select it, but for now we will select it as perfect conductor, because in our example it was nearly about perfect conductor, because you can see our conductivity is very large, so we can select perfect conductor. But if you have your data sheet for your substrate, then you can choose the exact thing from your data sheet. And thickness is 70 micrometer. In see here, it's 70 micrometer. And below cover is also a perfect conductor and which have a thickness of 70 micro. So our substrate is ready. You click save. So substrate is ready. Yes. Now we'll go to our EM setup and you see the error is gone because we have a substrate now. And other thing you can just check. Generally, for this example, we don't need to change anything. Everything have their own objectives, but in this, like for simple design like this, we don't need to change anything much here. But if you want to change anything, you can always refer to help document to see which things actually referring to what. But for now, we will keep everything default. Okay, so we'll close it. Yes, and we'll open our layout. And we can do the EM simulation now. EM simulation is running. It will take a little time and it's done. And you can see we have some result here, but this result are dirty, like they are not of our use because they are signifying nothing, because we have one gap. We have one gap here and nobody in this simulation, they have considered it as gap only. But what we are designing? We are designing it for a SNP box. So we don't need to see this result, no issue, like we'll just ignore it. After that, what we'll do, we'll go to EM and we'll go to component, and in component what we'll choose create EM model and symbol, because for COSIM we need the symbol, right? So we'll click here and we'll click here and it will show that created. So done, we can close it safely. So now we will do the COSIM simulation part. So what I will do, I will create another schematic and I will write this name as COSIM and create the schematic. Always keep this in mind, like you should, your folder structure should have some organization, otherwise you will get confused like which folder have what. Okay, so like I have given the COSIM first step, second step, so you should maintain like this. Okay, so in COSIM, I'll go here and I can see nothing here. So I need to bring the symbol of the created layout and this is your symbol. So I'll bring it here. I'll drag it here and here I have it. Okay, now in box here, what we'll have? We'll have that box. So let us copy it. You can copy this box from the schematic or you can again select one SNP box, again select the file for the S2P file. You can do all these things, but easy is to just copy it from here and paste it here. Okay, let's join the wire and your term G here and term G here, connect both of them. Now we need to have one SP which should go from 5 GHz to 7 GHz because 6 GHz is our center frequency. Now we will run it and we are expecting a result close to our previous result, but we will come across one error. Let me show you this error, and I know how to solve this error, but this is kind of jugaad. I know if you know the exact way to solve it, please comment it down. But how I solve it is that, see, in your step 2 you have layout here, right? And you have a schematic here also, and this schematic is just to create that layout, because in that schematic we have just given that gap here. So this schematic is actually has no value to us, and this error is coming mainly because of this layout and schematic are in the same cell. So what I do, and which is just a jugaad, I don't know the exact reason. So what I do, I just delete it and I can delete it because I already have the original schematic in another cell, so no issue of losing the available information. Now if I run it, it should run without any error. Let us see it. Yeah, it got run done. S11 and S21 and add DV, and let's see, our gain at 6 GHz is around 11.20, and if I am not wrong, in last in schematic after optimization we have able to achieve 11.36, and maximum gain is possible around 11.37 from MATLAB. If you see our lecture 11, there I have calculated the maximum gain using MATLAB, so there it was coming 11.37 or 38, and we are able to achieve around 11.36, but here we have a little bit dip, but it's all okay, not an issue. And at 6 GHz our S11 is also like handsome, not so bad, not so good also, it's less than minus 10 dB. And this change, like this deviation of result are coming from the schematic, is because of the EM thing, because in EM we have many other effects also. We also take this non-continuity, capacitive effect, parasitic inductance, there are many effects are there, so because of that we get some deviation from the schematic result, but still we can do good thing, we can optimize this layout, and I will do that thing in my next lecture.
Hey, so the layout I have shown you, that was very simple because I was not using this DC biasing network there, because that layout was not complete. So if you want to complete your layout, then we also need a DC biasing line, because when we will fabricate in our substrate, we need to give the DC biasing from externally, so we need to have some path. So for that, here I am using lambda by 4 lines, and why lambda by 4, it have some its own reason, I am not explaining it here. If you want, in some later video I can explain it. In simple language, this lambda by 4 let us do the RF choking part, and as we are dealing with high frequency, we can't use a lump RF choke here. So lambda by 4, and lambda by 4 means it will be lambda by 4 in your center frequency. So, and detailed explanation I am not going to this do in this video, it will take time. So so this is your full layout, but you might be seeing it like I am using some snake type of curving my lines, and in my other layout where I was doing layout, it was straight line, simple. So why I am doing this folding here? So main reason is we need to save our space. If it goes straight, then it will take a large amount of space, so we want to save it. But does it mean I can fold it any other way? No, you need to, because of this folding, there will be some extra parasitic capacitance will come in the place, and which will degrade our performance for sure. But we can make it as minimum as possible, and to make it, what we need to consider is that the folding, this space between any folding should be more than 5 times the height of your substrate. And how to do this type of folding? This is very easy. Let me show you. This was my layout which we were doing, and we already know the length of these lines. So what we can do, we just need to press the T button in our keyboard for shortcut, or you can directly click this one. Okay, so it will do what? It will insert the trace. So I'll click here, or you can click trace, and this is the weight. Actually it won't be auto populated, it will be around by default 25 micro or something, but we need it around 1488 for our example, so we will set it like this. And this is the end, like when you will end your trace, how it should be. It should be square, truncated, or round. They have their own significance, but in our design they don't have, because we are roughly designing it, so we will keep it square, no issue. And this is when we will fold it. It should be rounded, or it could be square, it could be mid-raised or curved, and these have their own significance. We'll select rounded one. So after that, you have selected your width, everything. Length will be selected because we know already the length we know. So what we'll do, we'll just click here and then see length. Here I can see length, like cumulative length, how much I need to go. So I can like go, and then if I want to fold it, then I can fold it, then I can fold it. So it's very easy. And when you want to finish it off, you just need to double click it. So it got finished. So by this way, what we do, we do the folding, and by folding we can save our space. So that's all for this video. In next video, I will take up the optimization part, how you can optimize your layout. Like in this video, we have seen our result was okay, good, but not best. So how to get the best result out of your layout, we'll see in our next video. Thanks for watching it. Bye bye.